And talking about putting the time in and doing quite a lot of work, we have our very, very final guest, and that's Dave, who's going to talk about probably, again, one of the best, between this and OTLA, the best opportunities you can get from my own experience, not having done the mentor programme, so, but from my own personal experience that you can do with the ETF. Dave.
Yeah, thanks, Dom. And you know what? It's interesting you said what one of the best experiences, but having not experienced the mentor. I just see in the chat just now and everybody lighting up with people who have been involved in it or tried to apply. The reason why I think this sits alongside the what sounds like an incredible program for the mentor program is because it provides opportunity, time and space and some funding to support you. This was wholeheartedly agree with Dom, a massive game changer in, I think we've talked previously, and I'm sure you all have conversations at your own institutions about, you know, an ever squeezing set and more that we're expected to do. But sometimes when we find an absolute gem of something, you can find the time and your passion just drives you on and it filters down to the stuff you're doing day to day anyway. This was and is it for me. And, you know, wholeheartedly, again, this was from I'm going to go back to what Becky said. This was a corridor conversation. Gateway entry with Dom. We were in a teaching and learning room at college and he said, what do you think about this? Have you heard about this? Do you fancy getting involved in? And that was what how it began. So I'm ever hopeful that this is similar and I can cascade that out to other people as well. There are several people at our college who've signed up to this and who are involved in it now. Jasmine Corson, are you on the call as well, heavily involved in this and probably deep in your research? But this is a fully funded program or almost fully funded program by the Education Training Foundation, and it works with Sunderland University. There are two options here for this program. I know we're close to the end of finishing, so I'm not going to dribble on about this, I promise, but I do want you to latch onto this opportunity now. The two are, one is an MA short course. It's a year-long fully funded program where if you've got a good research idea, but maybe you need a little bit of support in how to think and to create some time, how to make it happen, the MA short course is a fantastic starting point. You're on it for a year. You have residentials up at Sunderland University where you go up there into Sunderland. It's actually the hotel. They take over the whole conference room. And Maggie, who's the lady on the screen, Professor Maggie Gregson, is one of the mentors on it, one of the leads on the program. Very much dispels the myths of academic snobbery and support you with being a practice-based researcher, which just empowers what you're doing in the classroom and gets your voice out there in the sector. And at this level, you start to have contributions towards nudging, you know, policy itself. So you've got the MA short course as a stepping stone if you're looking to bridge the gap to it, build some of the skills. Slightly smaller project, and you do your research project. It's about 3,000 to 5,000 words. There's about three residentials that you go to throughout the year. At the moment, they're obviously online, but they're doing some incredible stuff with that as well and connecting people from across the country. But there's also the ETF MPhil program. Lots of people train from the MA short course onto the MPhil, but you can go directly onto the MPhil program as well. And MPhil is a little bit different to a master's itself. The MPhil is the stepping stone onto your full PhD should you look to do it. And what I will say is that if you fancy that, if that's your long-term goal, and I say if, that's not where I'm heading with it. I'm cutting off where I'm at the MPhil, thank you for now. But the MPhil program is the gateway and you can be heavily supported to just build your confidence and your opportunities and your understanding of how to work and research at that level and have your work read and heard. Part of the program is you get an opportunity to talk at conferences that the ETF host and run. There a shameless picture of me talking at a conference there. What a seamless transition. Sorry about that. I very nearly wore the same shirt. Realised that I better not this evening. The avenue I went in onto this was at the very bottom, the sort of online digital technology strand and Dom and I's work on the teacher's takeaway and the ability to share good practice and what we mean by good practice online. But these are the four main priority areas of interest. What's wonderful, if you look at the first two and bear in mind what you've all been involved in and the reason why you're here, it all started with talking about English and maths. So if you've got an idea, if you are looking at developing your teaching skills and conducting research into your own practice or developing your understanding a bit more about research practice, and these are your themes, then you're onto an absolute winner. They will obviously consider anything and a whole range of projects, but these are the four key priorities that they're looking at the moment. So if you're thinking teaching and learning assessment in English and maths, maybe you're trialing some stuff. If you're thinking about the embedding of English and maths, are you more of a, you've got a vocational strand that you're focusing on. I'm instantly drawn on that first one, Becky, to the stuff you were talking about before, the culture of reading and maybe taking that on the next step. The embedding of English and maths touches on so much of us, very much so on the level one and two program teachers, but everywhere else as well, as we know. And then to open up further afield, just in general, developing effective teaching methods and to analyze your own practice and how you can develop them further. Or like I say, and there's probably a huge explosion for this as well, looking at research on online learning and digital technologies. So this is an annual program. It's been going for about 9 years now. I can't recommend it enough. If you think a master's and MPhil program will probably sit you back about £6,000 anyway, you get funding to attend the events, which paid for our transport. All of our accommodation was paid for. All of the food and meals were paid for where you were there, and you get to eat and talk to your colleagues as well. And the opportunity to get involved. The only cost you'd be paying is £500 towards in the second year of your MPhil qualification. So £500, granted a fair bit of work as well, for a MPhil is a fantastic opportunity. And yeah, just a real nod to everybody on the program. And I can't push it enough. Applications will open up for next year. Applications open up in the summer this year, 2021. So summer 2021, have a little look. I am going to say, if you're interested and you want to get involved, there are five or six people at HSDC, myself and Dom included, and Jazz who are included. Reach out if you're worried about completing the form, or you want us to have a little lookout over completing the form, then please do. I had Dom to piggyback over and to support me through the process, and hopefully have worked with some of my colleagues to do the same. So it'd be really nice to open that out. I'm going to stop there. Some people have probably looked at the clock and gone, that's 2 minutes over. But I'm going to finish and say thank you very much. Dom, I'm going to hand it back to you, and I'm just going to drop in the feedback form whilst you're talking. Okay.